In Genesis, the 29th chapter, the 21st verse, the Bible says, "And Jacob said unto Laban, Give me my wife, for my days are fulfilled, that I may go in unto her." Beloved, God wants to bring you a special message today. A lot of times, a lot of believers have been programmed to think that certain things that God has made freely available for them, they still have to beg for it, to plead for it, to ask as though they have not now earned it as a right and gift from God. If you look at the verses, the Bible says that the man of God, Jacob, goes on to speak clearly to his father-in-law, "Give me what is mine." At some moment in our life, as we grow older in the things of faith, we must come to the consciousness and the realization that certain things are not favors to us, but actually our rights as children of God. When Jacob realized that he had done everything, he was not scared to look at the father in the face and say, "Give me what is mine." We see this demonstrated and encouraged by God at several points in scriptures. God loves it when we come in the consciousness of who we are to Him. In fact, that is why He says, "Come boldly to the throne of grace to obtain mercy and to find grace in time of need." Not just to come to plead and to beg. No, He says, "Come boldly." He didn't say come timidly. He didn't say come in fear. He says come boldly. About finances, for example, in the book of Malachi, the 3rd chapter, we see God say that we can prove Him. Another translation says, "Dare me now." If you have brought in the offerings and the tithes, if you have brought food to my storehouse, God says, "I want you to dare me right now. I want you to place a demand on what is your right." Beloved, we have a spirit of boldness and not a spirit of timidity. We must not approach God as though He is mean or wicked, or as though He is not our Father. We must approach Him knowing fully well that we have made peace with Him by Jesus Christ, and so we do not have to, as though sound like we are insulting Him or not having faith enough in who we claim to be. Beloved, there are things that God has ordained for the believer that He has freely given that we cannot begin to experience until we begin to place demands, until we begin to lay claim, until we begin to say, "Give to me that which is mine." There are a lot of blessings that God has left in the hands of, say, an enemy or even of nature that you must claim, that you must begin to possess. A good example we see in scripture to further make us to understand and believe that a believer must demand for some things that are his is the story of the prodigal son. Many times we have misunderstood that story, and we have read it and understood it from only one perspective, from the errors and the wrongs of the prodigal son. But in reality, if we follow the story, besides the problems, which were obvious, there were certain principles that were absolutely adhered to. For example, when the younger and the prodigal son walks up to the father, he is able to say, "Father, give to me that which pertaineth to me." And the Bible says the father goes ahead and gives to him. The problem was not his demand of what was his. The problem was his immaturity and his erroneous way of living, where he became riotous in living and squandered the things. But we have forgotten that if he, like the story of the man with the talent, if he was able to prosper and multiply the things which he got from the father, that it would have been a good story. So hear this. Why did the master, his father, give him what belonged to him? Because by right, it was his. And there was no problem whatsoever in laying demands on the father. Child of God, God is saying, there are things I have made for you. There are things that belongs to you. that you must place a demand on. We remember also the story of the brother to the prodigal son. The Bible says, after many years, when his younger brother returned and was being celebrated by his father, he was angry because he says, I have been with you for all these times and not once did you kill any animal for me, nor did you even dress me up properly or put a ring in my finger. And the father says, all that I have has been yours. You could easily have taken from anything. You could have placed a demand. Beloved, how many times and how many things have you failed to place a demand on God about? Have you placed a demand on God as a right for your husband? Have you placed a demand on God as a right for your wife? Have you placed a demand on God as a right for your children, for your health, for your well-being? Beloved, as we grow and as we mature, there must be a level of maturity where it is absolutely okay for there to be demands. Ideally, a husband should be able to place demands on his wife, and a wife should be able to place demands on the husband, and parents must be able to do the same to their children, and children also to parents, to say to them, give me what is mine, without any form of animosity, because this is appropriate and it is of the Lord. This is what we see Jacob applying in this verse. He is applying a principle of placing demands and saying, God, give me what is mine. And we realize and we know this was not the last time he would do it. When he wrestled with an angel of God, he says, I will not let you go until you bless me. And the Bible says, God wrestled with him and the man got his blessings. How many times have believers let go of what was theirs just because they didn't know they needed to place a demand for them to experience that blessing? Child of God, God is calling you today. God is reminding you that you can surely have what is yours. It is absolutely normal to place a demand on what is yours. Jesus encouraged this attitude when he allowed the woman with the issue of blood to approach him, and she came from the press behind and she touched his garment and she pulled out what was hers. When they tried to stop Jesus from performing miracles and healing people, Jesus would say, ought not this one, being a daughter of Abraham, be set free? Because it was her right and she had the right to earn that healing. Jesus Christ encouraged it when people opened up his roof and let down the sick. Jesus loved it when people screamed his name out, saying, Son of David, heal me. They were placing a demand on what was theirs. They were ready to cash out their blessings from God. We also must develop this character and attitude where we can place a demand on nature. We can place a demand on the devil and say, release what is ours. We can place a demand on God and say, God, give me what pertains to me in this life, and God will be glad to honor our request. No wonder the Bible says, ask. Jesus is speaking. He says, ask. And if you ask and don't get it, he says, don't stop there. He says, seek. And if you do not find it, he says, knock, and the door shall be opened unto you. Beloved, we must learn to place a demand for the things which are ours. In following that scripture, we realize that Jacob, our father, had served for his wife. Beloved, when you have served God in all sincerity, just as the Apostle Paul could call and say he had served God all his life and say it boldly, if you've done so, then there are certain things that are your right in God. There are your rights. There are things you have to demand for. Can you imagine if Jacob had not demanded for his wife, he was to continue in singlehood for a long time? There are people who have stayed longer in singlehood than necessary because they have failed or not known that they were supposed to place a demand on God and not just to plead with God or to pray. As you become a more mature Christian, you don't just plead with God. You must know your rights. For example, in the court of law, you are celebrated, you are attended to on the basis of your rights in the Constitution. You must realize that God honors his word as law. You must lay claim to your husband. You must lay claim to your wife. You must lay claim to your blessings that you demand and expect from God. Jacob served for 7 years and wasn't given what belonged to him. Jacob served for another 7 years to now get the woman whom he loved. He served for another 7 years to get riches, and it was not being given to him until he began to demand for it. When he demanded in the realms of the spirit, he started seeing the blessings that he wanted. And that was the way he left the house of Laban prosperous. Beloved, what blessings of yours are out there that you have not demanded for? God is speaking to you now. Place a demand. Lay claim to it. Say, give me what is mine. And say it in faith and boldness, not in arrogance, but as one who has come to the consciousness that he or she has something in God. May God bless you and God help you to work in the consciousness of what is really yours. Amen.